Good afternoon, everybody. My name's Kristen Fletcher. I'm the community outreach and programs manager at the Hailey Public Library, and I'm so thankful that you're here today. It's a beautiful day outside, and I'm glad that you took the time to come and join us. Our presentation today is the final presentation in a four-part series we've called Cultura. And it's the purpose of this series is to have a conversation with people who live in our community or are friends of community members who call a country in Mexico, Central and South America their homeland. So we've looked at El Salvador, we've learned a lot about Peru, we had a wonderful visit to Oaxaca, and then today we're going to learn about Colombia, specifically Cali, Colombia. Our guest is Mauricio Molina, and his presentation is really going to be his biography, so I'm not going to give you any more of a biography than that, but please join me in welcoming Mauricio Molina.
Thank you. Hello, everybody, how are you? It's a pleasure to me being here in this amazing state. It's my first time here. It's a pleasure to bring my experience as a music teacher and tell you about my country and my city. Colombia, my beautiful country. Colombia, it's in South America, next to Venezuela, next to Panama, next to Peru, next to Ecuador, and Brazil. And my city, Cali, is the second city in the country. Yeah, the second largest city. The capital is Santa Fe de Bogotá. It's Bogotá. And Cali is to the left, near to the Pacific coast. Uh-huh. And the weather is too hot. It's sunny all the time. We don't have stations, is that the name? We don't have like winter, what is the name?
Seasons.
But we have sun or some rainy days, no more. But the people is too fun, is happy all the time. Enjoy the music. We enjoy to dance salsa. Salsa is a Puerto Rican or Cuban or New York music, but we adopt that music. We are spread to dance that kind of music, salsa and Caribbean music. Yes, thank you. Colombia was a cradle of our early human civilization. Yes, the indigenous people was before that what called Colombia, and now we have three kind of race. We have Indian, Afro-Colombian people, and a little bit white people. Okay, as you can read, that the Spanish conquistadors, that's right in between 1499 and 1529. Okay, I want to, could you please next? I want to, yes, this is my, okay. That picture is in Cartagena. But in Cartagena, we have that beautiful woman, with beautiful girls, selling fruits around the town, around the city, with the typical dresses. And have you been in Cartagena? Oh, you, okay. Cartagena is beautiful. Beautiful place that we have in Cartagena, beautiful beaches and beautiful places to listen to music and dance and eat delicious food. Okay, you please next. Okay, my beautiful Cali, nicknamed La Sucursal del Cielo in Spanish. Okay, is that the branch of the heaven. Some people knows a little bad things about Colombia or my city, specifically my city, because we had problems with the violence and some more trouble with, I know it's bad things, you know, but, oh, I love that picture because that picture is my one of my theories when I played when I was a kid, the yellow one. Is that Teatro, yes, Teatro Municipal, Enrique Buenaventura, in Cali. This is El Gato, or the cat. It's a beautiful, how do you say, like monument?
Sculpture.
What do you say? The word. Next to the river, next to the principal river in my city, in Cali. You can enjoy art, nature, food, you can dance, you can enjoy sports. And Cali has so good musicians. The main music that they play is, or we play, is Latin music. And right now, there is a lot of people from Cali living here in USA, playing and recording music for famous artists like Marc Anthony, like Jennifer Lopez, like okay, a lot of people. Because in Cali we have like good feelings playing the instruments more than just read or play something like simple. The most important thing for us is like feeling the music. That's the reason for musicians are very famous in Cali. Next, please. Oh, this is Festival del Pacifico, Petronio Álvarez, that picture. As you can see, that picture was last August, that picture. I have a group, my group is Mavichi, and we were playing in that festival. 45,000 people, between 45,000 and 50,000 people. It's the most important festival, Afro-Colombian music. We use drums, like natural drums, like in Africa. Yeah, imagine like drums like you can hang in your neck and play like this, like African rhythms, With drums, with keyboards or basses. And my groups use marimba, violin, two violins, and drums. That festival is like 6 days non-stop music, food, performance, dancing. You have too many places to buy a present, you know, like earrings, like typical presents. It's so good. You should to go. You should to go. Yeah.
What is the time of the year?
Sorry?
What time of the year?
It's the second week in August.
August.
Agosto. Okay, and that picture is in El Salsódromo, or a salsa line attracting of hundreds of salsa dancing schools in the street of Cali. Yeah, it's like a parade, and the last week of the year, December 25th or 5th to New Year, to December 31. 31st? Okay. It's only salsa, only dancers, salsa. It's like, you know, maybe around 2,000 dancers for the whole street. Salsa dancer. You can watch some videos on YouTube in the Salsódromo. That's an amazing experience. And the people is all the time happy, you know, like, hey. All the time is party. Okay, next, please. That's me. When I was a kid, I was part of an orchestra, salsa orchestra. The name was La Charanguita de Luis, the master, the founder is Luis Carlos Ochoa, is his name. Luis Carlos Ochoa. The name of the orchestra is La Charanguita. And we were in making, we did tours from Europe, Netherlands, Spain, Switzerland, Germany, and then Cuba, Mexico, New York, and around the Colombia, around the country. It was an amazing experience. I was one of the three singers. I didn't play the violin in that orchestra. But people was enjoyed our performance in Netherlands, you know, because it's awesome to see kids playing and dancing salsa and singing the salsa. Everybody start to dance with us. It was an amazing experience. I was skinny, no belly. Thank you. Next, please. Oh, that's the. Okay, that's my. How do you say, like, my town home, like, hometown. Because it's my alma mater, my university. It's like college. No, it's a university. Yes, Universidad del Valle, or University of the Valley. When I started, when I get my degree in music, as a teacher, music or musician, as a violinist, this is the building of the music or arts. That one is the building of the library. Yeah, that one, library. This one is the music building. And the picture in upper there is the conservatory. Antonio Maria Valencia is when I start to learn music when I was a kid. That was my first time in music was in that place. And then when I was like 19 years old, I start my university studies in Universidad del Valle. Okay, next please. This is a gorgeous guy. That's me playing in social events. I have my own business here in this country, in California. The name of my own business is Mau Violin Entertainment. And I bring my performance for social events like weddings, quinceañeras. Do you know what is quinceañeras? Yeah. It's a party for 15 years old girls. Mm-hmm. I play for any kind of events. So if you need a violinist for your event, please call me. Yes, I can fly for.
The question.
Oh, you have a question?
No.
No.
No, he answered it. Yeah.
But it's not captured in the
video. Oh, the question is if I live in LA. Yes, I live in LA, but I can move wherever the people call me. Mm-hmm. I have three kinds of violins. The regular violin wood that I play in that picture. To the left is a Yamaha electric violin, SV, like silence violin. And the white one is this one. It's my new baby. It's five strings violin. It's LED lights electric violin. We can use for records using MIDI. They have like more things for technology, you know, for recording or playing, making loops, or I can use some pedals and have some effects. I hope to buy like 9 or 10 violins, 9 more, different violins, but step by step. Yeah, next picture, please. Yeah, that's the last one. Oh, with my group, Pacifica Music Group, Mavichi, I won the first place as a best violinist in that festival, Pacific Music Festival, that you saw the picture with 48,000 people. That's the picture when I am receiving the award. And that's a very, 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 very good experience to me. Thanks God. God is good. No, in Cali, Colombia, in the festival the festival is in Cali, Colombia, Pacific Music Festival. Remember the Afro-Colombian Pacific Music Festival? It's music from, can we watch some video about Mavichi? You have? Oh, okay. Yeah, that's my group. That's my guys. Right now, we are 10. In this moment, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We were 8, but right now we have 2 more people playing.
What are the instruments in your group?
Yeah, it's the instruments are, that one is like a snare. but a little bit bigger. We use a drum, a typical drum, like African drum. And two violins, marimba, and one instrument that you play like this, it's like a guitar, but it's not a guitar. The name is tiple. It's a Colombian instrument. Tiple, the sound of the tiple is similar to the tres cubano or cuatro puertorriqueño. Like, it's a typical instrument. I can find in YouTube maybe somebody playing the tiple. It has a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful sound. Tiple, two violins, snare, and African drum, and the singers. Oh, and maracas. You have maracas over here. Excuse me, maracas. Okay. Yeah, Grupo Mavichi. Mavichi. In Spanish, Mavichi means first it has two stories about what means. The first was Mavichi Ma Marimba. Marimba. V violino violin. Ma V and Chi Chirimia. Chirimia is a group from typical African music. It's the group. Ma Vichi. But right now we have another reason for that Ma Vichi. M, music. In Spanish, musicas. A, the A is in Spanish is A, is ancestrales. Like yeah. V and E, or V and I, violins. Músicas ancestrales de violines. C, like contando, it's like telling. Telling or contando. And H and E, histories or historias. Or telling histories. In Spanish, it's músicas ancestrales de violines contando historias. Okay. Next, please. Oh, it's a video. Look at what a beautiful girl. She's from Santander de Quilichao. Black girl, give me a kiss.
Cuando veo esa hermosa negra, a mí el corazón se me agita. Yo daría lo que fuera por besar esa boquita. Todo el día pienso en ella, me siento medio embobado con su carita tan bella, su porte y su caminado. Yo no entiendo qué es lo que me pasa, pero me tiene enamorado. Ya no quiero ni estar en mi casa por andar siempre a su lado. Yo no entiendo qué es lo que me pasa, pero me tiene enamorado. Ya no quiero ni estar en mi casa por andar siempre a su lado. Negra linda, dame un besito, no me dejes con las ganas. Ahí dámelo despacito, que me dure hasta mañana. De la mano quiero agarrarte y sentirte bien cerquita. Fijamente poder mirarte, tu boca negra bonita. Yo no entiendo qué es lo que me pasa, pero me tiene enamorado. Ya no quiero ni estar en mi casa por andar siempre a su lado. Yo no entiendo qué es lo que me pasa, pero me tiene enamorado. Ya no quiero ni estar en mi casa por andar siempre a su lado.
Aprieta. besito.
Negra, dame un beso. Solo te pido eso. En tus labios de cerezo. Yo quiero estar preso. Si no me das un beso, mañana regreso hasta que me ponga a temblar los huesos. ¡Ay!
¡Ay, negra, dame un besito!
Aunque sea de medio lado.
Ven y dame un suavecito.
Are my students or ex-students?
¡Ay, negra, dame un besito!
Como a nadie hayas besado.
Ven y dame un suavecito.
Yes. I wrote the whole song. The que siga la fiesta, or yeah, that's to dance.
So the people who are watching and the video cannot. So when you just call out a question, it's not captured on that. So if you can repeat the question, that would be
okay. Well, the last question was the tiple has the sounds like a 12 strings guitar. I say yes, or like a mandolin. Uh-huh, I say yes. The tiple, the sound of the tiple is like a mandolin. Mm-hmm. The last question was if I am the composer or the right. I wrote the songs. I say yes. The whole songs that we have, I am the composer. Using a cymbal like this, and with the other hand, the drum, boom, boom.
Empezó la fiesta, la gozadera, todos se alborotan, muevan la cadera, salgan a bailar, formando una fila, que mabichi suena, que el sabor de Son balanta, llega veneno, pipilongo, que suena en los cueros.
Son balanta, llega veneno, pipilongo, que suena en los cueros.
Del patí hasta son del tuno, tocan rosita y otros bambucos.
Del patí hasta son del tuno, tocan rosita y otros bambucos.
Siga el vacilón con grupo Mavichi, toma seca y arrechón, tumba catreviche, y que siga el vacilón con grupo Mavichi,
toma seca y arrechón, tumba catreviche, y que siga el vacilón con grupo Mavichi, toma seca y arrechón, tumba catreviche, y que siga el vacilón con grupo Mavichi.
Con baterimba,
que siga la fiesta.
Con puma blanca,
que siga la fiesta.
Al son de arara,
que siga la fiesta.
Con caña brava,
que siga la fiesta.
Con los grupos de guacheré,
que siga la fiesta.
Los de Villarrica,
que siga la fiesta.
Los de Suárez,
que siga la fiesta.
Colón de Timuca,
que siga la fiesta.
¡Suénalo, Mauro Molina!
So we have one more.
Okay, it could be el sabor de mi pueblo when we are using marimba. Yes, that one.
Si me preguntas de dónde vengo, por qué mi baile y mi sabrosura, yo te respondo que lo que tengo es una mezcla de razas y de culturas. Llevo la herencia de un canto típico de Cauca, Valle, Chocó y Nariño, toda la esencia de mi pacífico, mi gratitud, respeto y cariño. De haber nacido en la tierra de oro, señores, donde baila la luna al son de violines y de tambores. Hay tres razas bellas, india, blanca y negra. La tierra se alegra de ver la mistura que hay entre ellas. Hay tres razas bellas, india, blanca y negra. La tierra se alegra de ver la mistura que hay entre ellas. Que hay entre ellas. Hay tres razas bellas, india, blanca y negra. La tierra se alegra de ver la mistura que hay entre ellas.
Hey mom, dancing.
Y si usted me pregunta de dónde soy, yo le digo de la tierra del sabor, donde prenden la rumba con un tambor, se baila y se goza, no importa el calor. Y si usted me pregunta de dónde soy, yo le digo de la tierra del sabor, donde prenden la rumba con un tambor, se baila y se goza, no importa el calor.
Thank you so much.
Your lead singers have nice voices.
The voices?
Good voices.
Oh, thank you. We have typical voices. It's a different way to sing. It's not like ballad or pop music. No. It's more like this, you know. It's like African voices singing. You know, like, for example, like this. Amanece y amanece, al amanecer y al amanecer el día, y al amanecer y amanece y amanece, y al amanecer y al amanecer el día, y al amanecer y al amanecer y al amanecer. Y al amanecer, y al amanecer. You know, like this. Thank you.
So that's the end of the PowerPoint. And Mauricio is going to play for us too. I wondered if we had any questions kind of in this little in-between period. And if so, I'll bring you a microphone to speak into.
Yeah, watching that YouTube video and then your group of people singing just remind me so much my experience when I travel in Mexico. So they have the mariachi band and also like a big group of people singing and playing music and people are dancing. And so I just wonder whether in Cali it's like everywhere you go, you will encounter like a musical group playing music and singing and then people start dancing. Is it like something very popular day to day or during weekend in your hometown?
Thank you. Thank you. The one thing that I can say is you should to visit us, visit my country. That's the only reason, the only way that you have you can feel what I'm saying right now. It's not the same that I'm telling you something that you have living the experience. People is too nice and so kind. And about the music and the sound of music, you can skip to dance. You start to listen to the music and you feel like your body is moving, like, you know, in your arms. It's a good experience. What else can I say? Let's enjoy our culture. We have too much for sharing for the world. And we have different, too much kind of music or groups or different places, you know, and that's the music in one part of the Pacific coast in Cauca or Valle, but in the whole coast we have different groups and different instruments and different kind of music or rhythms, two different. Between one city to another city, driving 1 hour, you have too much difference between them about the music. In that place, you move your body in this way. In the other city, it's different. It's jumping, or it's like, you know. Yeah, it's too different. We have a lot of rhythms to enjoy.
Mm-hmm. Mauricio, do you find that, are they out in the streets just casually playing on the street corner, mm-hmm. Just like busking, that's a term we have, where you just like walk down the street and you'll see musicians mm-hmm. playing on
yeah.
the street?
That's real. It's not like in the whole city, it's not, but it's in specific places. You can walk around and you can see groups playing the drums, the congas or bongos, or timbales, or the cowbell or the claves. You know what is claves? Jam block? No, I don't know what's the name. Like this. And singing and dancing. People take out the speakers to the street and enjoy the party, street party. Uh-huh. And drink some aguardiente, is the typical liquor from my country, aguardiente. It's like from Mexican, it's tequila. El tequila is for Mexicans. Aguardiente is for Colombian people.
Is it from sugarcane?
Yeah.
The question was, is it from sugar cane?
Oh, yes. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
And I apologize for my English because I'm still learning. I have only 2.5 years in this country, and I promise get better for next time.
it's much better than my Spanish.
Thank you. But I need to speak English because I'm living in this country. I need to get better. That's
Mauricio,
my goal.
When did you start Mavici?
I started when 6 years ago with my student, because I was a violin teacher in an institute. The name of the program is TIMCA in Spanish, TIMCA. In Spanish is TIMCA. That means, in Spanish, Taller Integral de Músicas Caucanas y Colombianas. It's like taller is like, I don't know what is taller, but like, program of Caucan and Colombian music, that means. And I was the violin teacher, and I met like that guys when they have like they were like 10 years, 12 years old, when I were kids, they were kids, and now they are 25, almost 30 years, and I started that group because I all the time I was dreaming to play in the Petronio Alvarez Festival. I say one day I'm gonna play in that place, in that festival. That reason I call them and I tell, hey, let's do a group. The name is gonna be Mavici. That the sons, I have this son, I have another son. Yeah, and my students say, okay, let's do it. And I pray to God, next year, my beach is gonna be here in Idaho.
I think Herbert Romero is working on getting
you.
Your band here.
Thank
so,
you. I promise you're gonna enjoy it. You're gonna dance, I promise that.
Yeah. So what brings you to this country?
What, sorry?
What brings you to the USA from Colombia to here? Why you come here?
What brings?
Yeah.
About our music? No.
No, why did you move from Colombia?
Why?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
Why?
Oh, okay. Uh-huh. Because I used to travel here as a tourist. 10 or 12 years ago, I come with my family in this moment, my wife and my 2 kids. We went to Florida, New York, Chicago, LA, California. Okay. Because we have family and friends in those cities. But only 2 weeks, and then come back to Colombia. But I say, I want to show what I'm doing here in Colombia, in USA, because over there they have more opportunities for musicians. It's a great country to grow up as a professional musician, you know, and God has been good with me and gave me the opportunity to be here and to get my permanent resident. About my music experience, my musical experience and my cultural experience, that's I got the EB2 forget my permanent resident. It's for professionals or for people to have amazing skills. And thanks God and thanks for my experience, I get the residence. That's what I'm doing, showing my music, my country music, showing my culture, and showing my performance as a violinist. Next year, I want to become a teacher, music teacher in the elementary school or middle school, but I have to do a test for get credentials.
Mm-hmm. I have not really a question. I'd love to hear you play your violin now and maybe sing some more. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh, I can sing. I can sing. Okay. I'm start singing. Okay?
Mm-hmm. Folk music.
Mm-hmm.
So can you sing one at least?
Oh, I'm gonna sing one folk music. Okay. A cappella. Yeah.
And tell me what that title is and what is it about, you know, that you're going to sing.
Uh-huh. Okay. Let's say it like Avicii, let me 1 second. Yeah. Si me preguntan de dónde vengo, por qué mi baile y mi sabrosura, yo les respondo que lo que tengo es una mezcla de razas y de culturas. Tengo la herencia de un canto típico de Cauca, Valle, Chocó y Nariño. Toda la esencia de mi pacífico, mi gratitud, respeto y cariño. Tengo la fortuna de haber nacido en la tierra de oro, señores, donde baila la luna al son de violines y de tambores. Hay tres razas bellas, india, blanca y negra. La gente se alegra de ver la mixtura que hay entre ellas. Hay tres razas bellas, india, blanca y negra. La tierra se alegra de ver la mixtura que hay entre ellas. Thank you.
What is that?
Yeah, that is. Thank
Mauricio,
you.
What is the title of that song, and what was that song about?
The last song?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that song says about the people, the different kind of people in our country or in our city. It says, if you ask where I'm from. Si me preguntan de dónde vengo, if you asking me where are we from, I from, yo te respondo, ¿por qué mi baile y mi sabrosura? And you ask, why you are so good dancing and you have like so good feelings to moving, you know, dancing and singing. Okay, I answer you, yo te respondo that, in Spanish, yo te respondo que lo que tengo es una mezcla de razas y culturas. Es okay. I answer you that what I have is a mixer between race and culture and a big history. You know, is that the point? The son say. Uh-huh.
Thank you.
Can I play my
violin?
Oh,
please play. That would be wonderful.
But in the next song, I need you, please, you guys, help me with your claps, like this, following the beat, okay, the rhythm. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Now I'm going to play a salsa from Cali. The name is Cali Pachanguero. It's the famous song from my city.
What is the difference between a salsa beat and a rumba beat?
The question is, what's the difference between a salsa beat and a rumba beat?
Uh-huh. The salsa beat, okay, rumba in Cali, they call rumba for the meeting, for the party. Okay, let's go to one rumba. It's let's go to a party. That means rumba. But in Cuba, rumba is a genre music or rhythm music, rhythm or uh-huh. Rumba is in Cuba is like and the people is dancing like you know like this. This is rumba. But in Cali, in Colombia, rumba is a party. It's the moment, you know?
Oh, so it's not
a kind of music or dance. It's a party.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Then what makes salsa music salsa music?
Salsa. Salsa music?
What is salsa music?
Oh, like this? Let me show you. This is a salsa. You can dance it like this. And turn around. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And that was salsa.
Salsa. Yeah. And I can sing cumbia. Let me show you cumbia. This is cumbia. You dance cumbia like this. Using a harp. Woo! Cumbia. En esta canoa rancha que tú me mandaste a traer, ya viene rompiendo el agua solo por venirte a ver, mamá. En esta canoa rancha que tú me mandaste traer, ya viene rompiendo el agua solo por venirte a ver. ¡Ay! ¡Cumbia! ¡From Colombia! You gotta move your hips. Si mi compadre se muere, no es por falta de cuidado. Debajo de la cama tiene su plátano sancochado. Si mi compadre se muere, no es por falta de cuidado. Debajo de la cama tiene su plátano sancochado. Ay, adiós canoa, me voy pa' ver rayando la aurora, me voy pa' ver al son de la luna, me voy pa' verte rompiendo la bruma, me voy pa' verte, ay 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 adiós canoa, rayando, you say, me voy pa' verte, you, me voy pa' verte, me fui, me voy pa' verte, me voy pa' verte. Y esos panes pa' que son pa' comerlo con café. Adiós canoa, you, me voy pa' vete. Rayando la aurora, me voy pa' vete. Al son de la luna, me voy pa' vete. Rompiendo la bruma, me voy pa' vete. Canoita, adiós. Una mano, one man, one hand on your hip. And the other hand, rise it. Now you won't be sugar. Woo! Turn around. Yes. Rayando la aurora, me voy pa' vete. Al son de la luna, me voy pa' vete. Rompiendo la bruma, me voy pa' vete. Ay, pa' vete, ay, pa' vete. Pa' vete, ay, pa' vete. Ay, adiós, canoa, me voy pa' vete. Rayando la aurora, me voy pa' vete. Canoita, adiós. Colombia. Imagine that you have a skirt and you take your skirt and move like this. Move your skirt. Adiós canoa, me voy pa ahí rayando la aurora, al son de la luna, rompiendo la bruma. Ay canoita Dios, ay canoita Dios, adiós canoa, ay pa vete, vamos. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. This was just wonderful. Thank you for coming here.